Nevado Sajama. At 6,542 meters, it is Bolivia's highest peak, and painting it is my good friend Dominik Modlinski. He's a landscape artist from British Columbia, Canada, who travels the world to record its landscapes. And me? Well, I'm the guy behind the camera. My name is Scott Wilson, and we're in Bolivia for 6 weeks, and we'd like to invite you along on a little trip to explain what it is that Dominik does. This is Painting Journeys Bolivia.
We are going to La Paz, it's freezing.
All right, here we are in the beautiful Bolivian town of Coreco. It's about a 3-hour drive from La Paz. I am here with my very good friend, Dominik Modlinski, landscape artist. As you can very well see by the painting he's in process of doing of the surrounding valley as we speak. And we've actually just had a few days on the road. It's been kind of strenuous, so we're decompressing here, and we figured it'd be a good time for a little one-on-one interview with the artist in residence, Mr. Modlinski.
What it takes.
What it takes to be an artist. Okay, Dominik. Okay, first off, just a couple things. Like, I've known Dominik for about, 15 years?
Yep.
15 years. We have met many similar personality traits, which I guess is one of the reasons why we haven't killed each other yet on this trip. But it's been good. He's a very good friend, and I've always known that he's been a landscape artist. I've never really understood until this trip what it takes to do what he does. I always suppose that, you know, you take a couple pictures and you go back to the studio and you do a painting and away you go. Little did I know. This trip has been quite strenuous. Dominik, he's a true believer in going to the source. He's not going to sit back and allow something to come to him. He has to go to the source. So why is that, Dominik? Why do you pick these places and you forsake all your creature comforts and you go out into the bush for the periods of time you do?
One word that can really describe my objective is truthfulness.
All right.
Going after the truth. And truth is represented by here by many things. First of all, very physical travel, like you said, we're doing. Mm-hmm. So it's truthful. Going right to the source, being right on location, and painting it right there, and capturing the essence of the moment and the spirit of the place. And the truthfulness comes through the spirit of painting when I do that. At least that's how I think, and that's how I always base my creative objectives.
So do you believe there is more life in a painting that you create on location?
I like to think so.
Okay, because you're taking everything in.
Yeah, it's even so, sometimes, you know, we weren't filming or painting each day because we have to travel the distance, but nevertheless, my mind is like a sponge. It takes in the smells, the sounds, the feel of the road. And later on, when I'm gonna be in the studio, I'm gonna be looking at the sketches that I done and the photographs, I have the ability to recreate that essence.
Dominik's art comes from two places, painting in the field and painting in a studio. In the field, he paints sketches. They're usually oil on masonite, 11 by 14 inches large. And it is these sketches that he takes back to the studio to help him recreate that essence he spoke of. Here, climbing steps carved out of solid rock to the Horca del Inca in Copacabana and setting up to paint are all part of his process and all contribute later in the studio.
So, sun is going down on the famous Lake Titicaca on the shores of Bolivia. We're in Peru, Chile, finally Bolivia. This is our kind of a primary destination for the jumping point to Isle de Sol, which is over there. So I'm very much looking forward to painting in the Isle de Sol because it's a very unique and treasured place for the local population. And of course, it was a very treasured and sacred spot for the Inca Empire.
El pueblo es Chayapam. Chayapam. Entonces, primero de acá se visita museo, y después compra el ticket.
Sí.
Y con ticket de acá caminando, llegar acá todo el tiempo.
After our little introduction to the island, we headed for Chincana, a set of Inca ruins at the north end of the island.
Well, every landscape you travel to, especially a new one, is a new light for an artist. And here we are in Bolivia, close to 4,000 meters on the Lake Titicaca, extremely beautiful blue intense sky reflecting from very light rocks. So it takes a while to learn how to paint and find the language, technical language and a brushwork to find how to paint those rocks contrasting with the very big mass of a blue sky and sometimes big volumes of the white clouds.
So you like this spot?
Yeah, it's gorgeous. So many angles.
So that's what you look for, is angles?
Angles, yeah.
Okay.
Angles, perspective. So, what is it? It's called surface form relationship. It's a, you're looking for diagonals.
Okay.
That creates a very active, dynamic composition instead of static.
So diagonals, and you're talking intersecting lines?
Correct.
Okay. Yeah, you got lots of that here.
And also contrast, light and dark. Also complementary contrast too. But here we're dealing more with dark and light. One painting here for sure, and then a painting of that pathway, doorway over there. Okay, go see your friend.
The next day we rose to glorious sunshine and hiked to Yumani on the south end of the island in the Temple del Sol, another set of Inca ruins.
Wow, isn't this amazing? Just got here very early in the morning. What I love to see here is the continuity of the shape of trapezoid that actually you see in the modern structures. They're still using it, but here we are discovering that's where it originated from. The doors and the windows are all elongated trapezoids. So I think I definitely try to concentrate on capturing that type of characteristic in the painting here. This is one of the best preserved Inca structures around Lake Titicaca on Bolivia side. To really express the power, the grandeur and the mythology of the place, I chose to go really thick with paint to express really the true powerful essence. So here we have fat paint over lean paint, which means thick paint over very washy kind of watercolor effect, which creates a really nice textural effect. I'm very happy with this painting that I created on site here on the Isle of the Sol.
It wasn't long before I really began to understand why Dominik did what he does. We have a tendency to rush through our landscapes. Dominik's approach is to seek them out, stop, take them in, and paint them.
When you deal with any kind of landscape, the appreciation and concept of handling light is the most important part of the successful work. So here, it's early afternoon and I'm dealing with many, many layers. So I'm starting from light to dark, basically, and also from lean to thick paint. So I slowly build up the texture. So my paintings always have this kind of a sculptural quality about them. And they relate to what I see in front of me in the easel.
After each painting was finished, I watched Dominik perform his little ritual. He'd photo each one, take GPS coordinates of the location, and then he prepared the painting for travel with a little help from nature. Pebbles, of all things. And once the painting was wrapped and stowed, it was off to find the next location.
Awesome, that's exactly what I wanted to see out of the whole trip. That transition between the snow altiplano into this lush cloud forest as we are dropping into the lowlands of Amazon. Butterflies, birds, and stinking hot. I gotta take off some of my clothes.
Dominik would stop frequently to assess, and from each assessment he would decide to paint, to photo, or to simply move on to the next spot.
We are on the road to Apollo, another town in the jungle, and the vegetation is getting thicker and thicker, bigger trees, banana trees, and beautiful waterfalls. Yeah, they're coming down from both sides of the cliffs into the valley. It's just unbelievable. I'm speechless.
And before long, Dominik found another spot to paint. This time, it was just on the side of the road.
Well, as you can see here, the storm is coming quite fast. So here we have an exercise in a very intuitive, responsive painting. I'm not really thinking about it. I'm just painting because the storm is coming. But anyway, obviously here is the exercise in values from an aerial perspective. The very far background is receding as the clouds are covering the mountains. And the mountains, the objects closer to you are becoming darker and warmer. Hopefully I'll be able to finish that painting before we get covered in rain and thunderstorm.
He did finish his sketch on time, and we avoided the storm, but not the night.
We're in this little town called Apollo, and we're supposed to be heading to another town, except we had a little problem.
There is no road.
Okay, we have a National Geographic map, which says there's a road, but...
Well, the National Geographic is all about adventure and exploration, and the road shows gravel, but it does not exist. It's in the projection.
Here we go. Hey.
Okay.
What do you say, Mr. Modlinski?
Last river crossing today.
So I dropped the bikes three times by now, yeah. Two on the ferries, that's all good. We got to some kind of a Catholic hostel. They're looking for a room, but looks so far the cleanest looking hotel. I will see how it is inside.
After 4 days and close to 400 kilometers from the northern Andes to the south, little detour, we finally got to Rurrenabaque back, which was our destination in the first place. We are going up the river to one of the eco jungle camps run by the local indigenous people. One of the reasons I wanted to see the jungle is because I'm always very interested in the forest interiors, but also Madidi National Park has a very incredible mountain scenery, a little bit different from what we've seen in the north. It's actually quite jagged, so it's a very various and varied landscape.
Gracias.
For example, this is the leaf in my community, the people they use for the camouflage.
Oh, okay.
That's gonna be permanent.
Look like a big beetroot.
Yeah. The color is the last for 1 year.
I can't get it.
Wow, what a beautiful color.
On this trip into the Madidi National Park, I didn't take my paints because we are using guides and there's not enough time to set up for paint. But it is an amazing opportunity to get reference material. And for me, reference material are so important also, just as the sketches on site. Because I paint on site for so many years, photographs give me a very good source of material, but it's just a source. On this I build up my own individual brush stroke, my individual color harmonies. And I hope through this trip into the Madidi National Park I will get some good reference material for the forest interior, but also of the shorelines and the mountains of this national park.
Good day, Mr. Modlinski.
Good day, Mr. Wilson.
How are you today?
Well, tired, but good, in a good mood. We got to Coraico, which is just north of La Paz, just before the Road of Death, and we're just enjoying the beautiful view. I'm taking some time off just to relax, decompress from the constant bouncing and doing the beautiful paintings of the beautiful vista here, looking down the valley. Sometimes it's good just to sit down and even use the hotel patio, because the body sometimes can't keep up with the mind, you know? So today is a more of a relaxing day, and I'm just staying put. We have a long journey ahead of us again towards the salt flats. Time is flying pretty fast when you're on the road and you're doing so many adventurous things.
Cerro Rico, Spanish for rich hill, was our next stop. Landscapes come in all forms, and our next one was underground in the Potosi silver mines, where an estimated 15,000 workers continue to mine. Now working in cooperatives, have more control over their days, but it remains a very dangerous profession with an average life expectancy of 45 years.
It's like the working place, working area belongs to him.
The Museum of Money in downtown Potosi tries to make sense of how an estimated 8 to 9 million miners have died in or on Cerro Rico. It's a fascinating museum and is housed in the old mint. From silver we pass to salt. The Salarduni are the world's largest salt flats and provided Dominik's next landscape.
Well, most of the time I work from light to dark. So, keeping the effects of luminosity, so the light color, light value is gonna come through.
From Isla del Pescado, we hit the road. Well, more salt, actually. We passed volcanoes, llamas, alpaca, and villages before stopping for the night in a hotel built from salt. Just about everything but the mattresses.
Quite often, it's a really neat idea to take your camera and really focus on the texture. Here you can see the surroundings are just basically huge playground for texture. Everything is deteriorated with time. And if you take your camera and you bring it close, it becomes a very abstract shape. Quite often I do that and transform that into large backgrounds, and it creates a beautiful visual effect. A lot of abstract artists use that as a foundation for their large scale canvases. Here you can see water damage, also very beautiful contrast created, shapes, surface form relationship, positive and negative shapes because of the windows and the background of the landscape. It's quite wonderful. Sometimes I do have very simple outlines of my subject matter that I paint, sometimes I don't. It depends how I feel and depends, you know, what type of weather it is. This is a little bit more complex, there's some water reflections here. Probably gonna paint a couple of flamingos, so yeah, that's why I'm using a little a drawing tool called Contour.
From the salt flats, we began our long journey home. But before we left for Canada, there was one final stop to make. Finally, we made it to Machu Picchu. It's after 6 weeks on the road, it's a beautiful place to end up at. Only 3 days left till we leave to Canada. Anyway, it's first thing in the morning, we left at 5:30, got a little bit of a sunrise and the mist coming through the mountains. It's a very quintessential look of the city below, and I'm looking forward to paint some studio paintings when we get back to Canada. Anyway, we'll shoot more when we get down to the complex. January 27th on the west coast of Canada, another beautiful day. I'm leaving my little island, Gabriel. I'm heading over to Nanaimo to see Dominik. I've been hard at work at the documentary and writing my book, and now I'm going to go over and see where Dominik's at with his paintings. I want to give one final shot here for the documentary, and then we should be able to get it out to you. Okay, we're here today. It's the end of January. We're with Mr. Modlinski in the Agawa Canyon. And Dominik,
in the Agawa Canyon?
In the Agawa studio, excuse me. Yeah, there you go. I pulled up. Can you explain to me a little bit what we're looking at?
Well, after we got back from Bolivia, I was so excited about my memories and impact that indigenous culture had on me, especially the clothing, in conjunction with its spiritual beliefs and the landscape. So I thought that maybe I'm gonna juxtaposition the image of the Incan sun god that you see here in the background with the indigenous boy dressed in a traditional clothing. And of course I always work with the strong contrast, warm colors, harmonies. So I think this one came out reasonably well. Also, as you can see here, a big symbol of the Andes Mountains, humongous condor feather. So normally we'll see something like that, it's an eagle feather which is that big, but the condor feather is actually that big. So the feather is going out of the frame of reference, is that big.
Wow. Okay, and for the viewer, what size painting is that?
This painting is 30 by 40 inches oil on canvas.
30 by 40 oil on canvas. And okay, all right. Beautiful painting. Beautiful. Okay, well, so basically we've gone through the planning, we've gone through the execution, we've gone through the sketches, the reference material, we're back in the Agawa studio.
Yeah, Agawa studio.
And now you're concentrating on the big stuff. And so once, for this particular show, any number of paintings you have in mind, or?
I'm probably aiming between 10 to 15 big paintings. I have so far already 3 paintings to go. I have quite a bit of time to complete, so there is no rush. And I'm taking my time to design each composition carefully and focus on the memories we had from the trip.
Well, excellent. So I would just like to say, Mr. Modlinski, it's been a pleasure. Thank you very much for inviting us into your studio, and hopefully we can do this again.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Excellent, very good guy.
Excellent guy. Ronaldo there.
Hey!
Hi, Canada.
He's awesome.
Good stuff.
There, Dominik.
Well, in about 20 minutes, we'll know who's the next president of the country of Bolivia. People hope it's going to be another term for the first indigenous president, Evo Morales.
And what the locals here said to us, it's a party. So you guys got to come down and check it out. This is live from Canada, from what's the town?
Canada, Bolivia.
Here.
I've never seen anything like that, never. In 20 years of my plein air painting.
Hey, Dominik.
Yeah,
Did you take your malaria pill today?
It's a good concept.
Okay.